36 years female with chronic angle closure glaucoma, undergone YAG peripheral iridectomy elsewhere twice and on two anti-glaucoma medication, was intolerant to acetazolamide, presented with left eye chronic angle closure glaucoma with cataract with intraocular pressure 48 mm of mercury with very shallow anterior chamber and 360 degree posterior synecchi. Patient do not have hypertension, diabetes or ischemic heart disease. She was not on any antiplatelet medication. Patient is not myopic. Her IOL power was 21 diopters. Her immediate preoperatively intraoperative pressure was 22 mm of mercury by giving mannitol. Intraoperatively, her vitals were normal. She was taken up for cataract surgery with trabeculectomy with mitomycin C. Patient had undergone surgery with scleral flap. Mitomycin C was applied and phacoemulsification was performed by stop and chop method. 360 degree posterior synecchi were noted but were not released. AC was completely flat and decision was made to do anterior vitrectomy with 23 gauge cutter. Anterior vitrectomy was done to create a space to make anterior chamber, which was done, and after that cortex was removed. Further AC was completely flat and so more anterior vitrectomy was done and then IOL was implanted. During this maneuver we tried to inject viscoelastic in anterior chamber but which was not possible. So decision was made to do anterior vitrectomy. After putting intraocular lens, 360 degree synecchis were released. No shallowing of anterior chamber was noted. Even intraocular pressure was well maintained till this time. After complete removal of 360 degree synecchi, there was small hyphema which was noted. We thought it could be because from sclerotomy site. Peripheral iridectomy was done. Blood was noted in the anterior chamber, which was a bit unusual. At this point, intraocular pressure was slightly higher. And one can see in the pupillary area, the red reflex has gone and I could see white reflex. So decision was made to immediately close sclerotomy and scleral flaps, which was done. And the wound was completely closed. At this time, intraocular pressure was not very high. You can see air bubble in the anterior chamber. But after removal of sclerotomy, one can see blood is coming from sclerotomy site. And that was because of suprachoroidal hemorrhage. To drain suprachoroidal hemorrhage, continuous irrigation was maintained from side port. And blood was drained as much as possible. At this point, there was completely white glow and I could see retina in the retrolental space. So we thought it is a suprachoroidal hemorrhage and we have decided to go in and we made three pars plana openings. Infrotemporal opening was made on the nasal side because we expect suprachoroidal on the temporal side. When we went in, temporal half of suprachoroidal was noted. So vitrectomy was done with PVD induction. Intraoperatively, the irrigating fluid height was kept high. Retina was detached, but we could not find any break. So we made a small retinotomy site and attached the retina. After that, we did air oil exchange, and one can see the temporal suprachoroidal was partially drained. AC was well formed and sclerotomy was closed. Postoperatively, after 6 weeks, visual acuity was 624 with oil inside. Unusual thing about this case was patient do not had any preoperative risk factors for development of suprachoroidal hemorrhage except intractable glaucoma, intraoperatively mild hypotony. Intraoperatively, patient do not had any eye pain. Patient is having unilateral chronic angle closure glaucoma with posterior synecdoche, which was quite unusual. There was no significant disc changes. So take home message is timely identification and watch at red glow, timely closure of wound, timely intraoperatively intervention by pars plana route could avoid blinding complication. Postoperatively, patient do not had any IOP rise. Thank you very much.